Are you thinking about putting your Boston Terrier on a raw food diet? In this video, I interview Amy. She's the proud mother of a Boston Terrier, Max, who's now 9 years old, and he's been on a raw diet ever since he was 6 months of age. Basically, this video, what I want to do is show you how simple it can be when putting your Boston Terrier on a raw food diet. Be sure to stay to the end because Amy's going to share with you a few tips that she has if you want to start this journey. Coming up. Hey everybody, welcome to the Boston Terrier Society YouTube channel. Consider subscribing if you're someone who wants to learn more about the breed, learn what it's like to be an owner, hear expert interviews, as well as connect with other Boston Terrier lovers just like yourself. I'm Donnie Gardner, the founder of BostonTerrierSociety.com. Over there is Bella, my Boston of over a decade. Today I want to do a little something different. I actually had the author of Home Cooking for Your Dog on a while ago, and Amy had put in the comments that she had had Max on a raw food diet since he was around 5 to 6 months of age. So I invited her to come on the show just to share with us her experience of basically, you know, transitioning Max onto a diet like this and what her method is for feeding Max raw every single day, basically how long it takes, as well as what her process is for coming up with meals. I think you're gonna get a lot out of this video because it's super simple, her process of doing it, and it's really the same for Christine's method in her book, Home Cooking for Your Dog, which I'll leave that in the show notes below if you wanna check that book out. So without further ado, let's get into the show. Well, Amy, yeah, jumping into this and everything, can you just tell me a little bit about yourself and Max before we get into the raw diet?
Yeah, of course. So my name is Amy. I'm from New York. Max is 9 years old. I had him when he was 3 months, and he is my first Boston Terrier.
So how long, because I know you saw the video on feeding your Boston Terrier raw and everything, how long have you been feeding Max on a raw diet?
So he started about maybe like 5-6 months on a raw diet. Yeah.
With that, because I know you mentioned a comment, so like how did you get started on a raw food diet? Like, was there somebody you followed or like a book that you'd read?
No, nothing actually like that. I actually have another dog. Well, it's more of my mom's dog, and he's on a raw diet. So at the time when he was about 5-6 months, I moved back in with my mom, and she had been feeding our other dog a raw diet. I wasn't crazy about the idea of giving him that because it is kind of time consuming. And yeah, it just felt like, you know, a dog should eat dog food. Like, it has probably the nutrition, the vitamins, and the minerals that a dog should be eating. But obviously Max saw that the other dog was eating like chicken and ground beef, and he obviously wanted to eat that as well. So I kind of like gave in the idea of letting him eating that, but I still integrated the kibble food. I would mix whatever meat we were giving him with the kibble food.
So it was all because of peer pressure then?
Pretty much, yeah. Like, my mom is not a fan of like kibble food or dog food. Like, she feels bad that dogs have to eat that, and she just doesn't think it's good for them.
Bella's not on a raw food diet, but I've been looking into it and everything. As far as like time consuming, how much time do you think, if you were just to add up, you know, what you're cooking for your dog, how much time does it take?
I try to get it done like the first meal of the day, just kind of have it for the rest of the day for morning and night.
Okay.
So I'll say maybe like 20 minutes. It's really not that bad.
Okay.
To be honest. Yeah, it's really not that bad. I also have a food processor, which kind of helps break down like chicken breasts and stuff like that. So I just like pop it in there, it just grounds it for me, and it's just there, you know, like I don't have to do it later either.
Okay. Yeah, because whenever I thought, you know, raw food diet, and honestly until like probably 6 months ago, I was just like, I wouldn't even want to mess with this or deal with it.
Yeah,
when I'm reading more about it, it seems like it's a doable process for somebody who, you know, lives a busy lifestyle like everybody does nowadays.
Yeah, it's definitely doable. Yeah, for sure.
Now, as far as making sure like Max gets, how do you do the amounts and making sure he's getting the right nutrients and calories? Like, is there something you follow as far as a formula?
To be honest, no, I kind of just like wing it. It's kind of like Christine said, the person you had on your, one of your videos.
The author of Home Cooking for Your Dog.
Yeah, it's a great video. And, you know, he has like a specific plan, you know, like medium bowl. I never like overfill it, and I don't underfill it. I kind of just keep it like 3/4. And it's kind of like what she said, without me knowing, you know, if he's losing weight, then, you know, you should probably be giving him more. And if he's like gaining weight, then probably cut down. Also with like whatever you're giving him. So he's fine. He's never like lost too much weight. He definitely put on some weight a little bit because my mom had been giving him kind of like rice like every other day. I wasn't aware of that because I had moved to San Francisco for a little bit and he stayed here with my mom. So when I got back, I was like, oh my goodness, like we need to like cut down on his food.
Yeah.
Like, he's super like chunky.
Yeah. And I think that's a good approach.
Yeah. Yeah,
Well, and kind of like how she had mentioned, because that was another thing that I was like, man, are you like having to, measure everything out? But when I think about like our diets, you pretty much
exactly.
just eyeball everything. And as long as you're going to the doctors annually for your dog and everything, getting him checked out, you should be good. What kind of meals do you cook for Max?
Pretty much like whatever we buy. We eat a lot of meat in the house, meat and vegetables. I'm pretty big on that. So when I go food shopping, it's frozen peas, carrots. We do go to Costco, so that helps because everything Costco is just like double the size. And they sell, those bags of like chicken breast. So we kind of stock up on that. And we do have two dogs, so it's a little bit more. So it does help. They tend to eat chicken more than anything, to be honest. But sometimes I do switch it to ground beef or turkey or sometimes even fish. Not always, but they do like it. So it's just kind of pretty much I just pick for the day. It's nothing like planned.
Okay, it's pretty much just like what you're eating almost.
Pretty much. Yeah.
Hey, I hope you're enjoying this video. If you are, consider subscribing to this YouTube channel just so you can get the latest from Boston Terrier Society. Back to the show. I do want to, as far as chicken, how well have they done with chicken? And the reason I ask is because I've seen a lot of people online saying, that Boston Terriers have had chicken allergies, which I just want to say, every dog is different. Some humans have allergies, some don't. So what's been their response to chicken and everything?
It's been great. I've never had an issue with chicken at all or any sort of meat. Never had an issue with like chicken or any other type of like meats that cause some sort of like allergy.
And then another thing on meal planning, just because I'm like, I was like, if I was to start this with Bella, like, where do I find meal recipes? Have you found any like maybe dog blogs that have recipes specifically for dogs or?
No, I haven't. I mean, I just keep it pretty simple. Like, I don't do anything crazy. I just stick to like just meat and vegetables. Like, I don't, razzle dazzle their dishes or anything like that. And they're totally fine with that. I was looking into like using chicken broth, like homemade, to kind of like give it like more flavor and not be so bland. And especially with Max, because I had mentioned in one of your videos that he had stones in his bladder about a year ago. And the vet told us that he needs to be like on a wet food diet. He's on a prescription food too that I mix with the raw diet. So I was looking into that to just like add more flavor, the food to be a little bit more wet and stuff like that. So yeah, I was looking into that.
The other thing too, which you didn't mention here, you're cooking all those meals, right? You're not doing straight raw.
Oh no, yeah, just cooking everything. Even the vegetables are like boiled or yeah, pretty much cooking, cooking.
And I know people that have had success with just raw. Me, it's just trying to get through that mental block as far as trying to give a dog complete raw, but I
Yeah,
know there's people that
I
have
don't
success doing
know.
it. So.
Yeah, I feel like something like that, you'd probably have to start from like when they're a pup or something to get used to something like that. Yeah.
Whenever you transition Max, because you said it was about the 5 to 6 month mark. So was he on a, I'm assuming just all kibble diet? How did that transition look?
Yeah, he was on just kibble. It was pretty easy. I mean, he was excited to be having something that wasn't that food. And he didn't want to go back to the kibble food. He did not want to eat that because there was a point where I was like, all right, like let's get him back on that. Like I just want him to stay on that, and he just wasn't eating it anymore.
Were you mixing in the kibble with the homemade food, or did you just kind of cold turkey him? I mean, at least he was familiar with it with the other dogs.
Yeah, so I tried to go cold turkey and just go back to kibble, but he just wasn't eating. So I would just go back to just mixing both of them.
As far as, someone who's thinking about putting their Boston Terrier on a raw food diet, is there any tips or advice that, if you going back in time that you wish you knew?
I think when I first started, it was just meat. It wasn't like vegetables or like fruits as snacking. I would definitely have them kind of do just a little bit of research of like what meats are good for them, what vegetables they shouldn't eat, what fruits they shouldn't eat as well. Like, I think it's important to kind of like make a list of what they can't eat and then just go with both. I think the whole vegetable and like meat is the combination is good. Not just like meat by itself. So that's what something I'd probably do different. I would have like added the vegetables like way sooner.
Whenever you added the vegetables, did you see any? Because I've heard people when they add the vegetables that their dog gets the runs. Did you see that with Max at all?
No, not at all. No,
Okay.
no run.
Just basically adding that fiber, I guess,
Yeah.
to go through them. Well, if somebody was wanting to reach out to you, Amy, maybe if they have any questions, where would be a good place for them to do it?
I'm on Instagram.
Yeah, and I'll put that in the show notes below.
Okay.
So in case somebody has a question, they can reach out to you.
Yeah, of course.
Well, thanks so much for coming on the Boston Terrier Society YouTube channel today. I really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, once again, if you want to reach out to Amy, in case you have any sort of questions or whatnot, her information is going to be in the show notes below. I hope bringing Amy on basically shed some light on, you know, you don't need to overcomplicate this when feeding your Boston Terrier a raw food diet. And just like she said, go ahead and start doing your research now on some foods that they can have, as well as some other recipes that you might find online. And always, 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 before you start your Boston Terrier on any sort of diet plan, contact your vet first just to walk them through what your plan is, and they're going to be able to give you much better guidance on your individual Boston. And if you want a good book to read, and this book helped me out, is Home Cooking for Your Dog. It's by Christine Filardi. It's going to be in the show notes below, and I actually did an interview with her, and you can check out that interview in the show notes below if you want to get started on a raw food diet. It's basically a beginner's guide, but it'll help you on your journey of feeding your Boston raw. If you want to learn more about raw food with your Boston Terrier, you can check out the playlist that I created here, or you can watch one of my latest videos here. And as always, until next time, life is better with a Boston.